gonna even do the long bridge. Because the long bridge, well,
I don't know how well that tape's gonna hold up on wood as far as slippage. And I don't know how wet that bridge is. I kind of think it's dry. You know what? We'll do that one bridge as we leave. We'll do one bridge. Give me that. And hopefully I'll catch a flat on my way out. God. So I'm at 20 PSI. The front tire's at 30 PSI. It's going to be a little bit of an uneven ride. These mirrors make for really good slides, by the way. And it helps you whenever the bike is flipped. Anyway. See how awful that brake sounds now. I'm falling apart. Look at that. And did you see all the scratches underneath? I'm not sure where all those scratches came from. I do know. There's this guy named Brandon. And Brandon doesn't really give a crap whether or not his stuff gets all scratched. And this is Brandon's bike. So that's kind of what happened. Kind of what happened, guys. You know, I am glad this was soft ground instead of scratchy old concrete. That always helps. Okay, we are ready to go home. God, I had such big plans for today. Kinda, but not really. Sorta. Well, take all my big plans and break them. That apparently was the plan today. We get one wooden bridge and we're going home. My bag feels funny. Look at all this dog poop, guys. I'm pretty sure there's a sign that says, you know, clean up after your pets. Well, apparently people don't respect signs anymore. Sorry about that. I wanted to check on the state of my Goess Proess, and I'm sure I blocked the lens. Goess Proess, it's the Roman version. I couldn't afford the American version. Tire feels okay. Man, talk about not having the best of times. If I'm gonna have a wobble in my back tire. Trying to straighten out that back rotor as I go. I don't hear it banging though. It looked pretty fucking crooked. Oh, that tire's got a definite wobble. This will be a fun ride home. If by fun you mean a little dangerous. Hey, look, it's my wagon guy. I can't remember where we saw him first. We saw him earlier. You know what, guys? Full throttle ain't gonna happen right now. It's a little too wobbly. So we are gonna do not full throttle. We're gonna do maybe 22 going home. That way if the tire blows out, you know, I don't have to use my helmet. Plus we'll give that hockey tape just a little bit more of a chance by going a wee bit slower. Shinko 241s. I'm going to get me some Shinko 241s. I don't know if I'm doing that tonight,
But soon I'm getting me some Shinko 241s. I've only got two tires at home, and they're both half worn from my old bike. And you know, that back stock won't last forever. And the tires obviously aren't good enough for everything I want to do. I'm pretty sure a Shinko 241 would have ate that stump. It like wouldn't have been a problem. And I'm pretty sure this bike isn't quite enough bike to wear them down anytime soon either. Like, I'll probably have a Shinko 241s on here for 4 years versus these have barely got me 1,050 miles. Shinko 241s probably give me 4,000 miles easy at least. So yeah, not a fan of the tires. Here I am limping home at 20 PSI, having worked my rotor and hockey taped my tire. And I am not feeling overly victorious today. That's how some days go. I probably left a bunch of parts back there too. That's fear talking. I got both of the tire stem valves. I got my tire tool. I got the cap that goes on the bolt that I didn't put back on. I've got the derailleur guard. I picked up my socket wrench, and I've got all of my Allen wrenches. So my net loss is probably pretty minimal. But here I am limping home. Fantastic. I hear it limping too. It's like a doot 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 doot. Right at about that pace. It's awesome. Well, hello, T-Couple School. I went to that school a long time ago. Like I said, you know, this is my hometown. I know everything about it. I think I know everything about it. I got confused earlier and thought the West Side Library was Willard Library. That's a completely different thing. But I know a lot about my home. How about that? I also know that if a nail hits my tire, or even a sharp rock hits my tire just right, I'm not gonna make it. Or hell, if I get another flat. Look at that little bitty smart car, like a penny racer. That's pretty cool. When I worked at Verizon Telecom, actually I didn't work at Verizon Telecom. Let me take that back. When I was working for Verizon Telecom through a contract company, there was a woman who worked for Verizon Telecom, and she won a smart car. And then they found out she cheated somehow for the raffle, like whatever it was, like how, like maybe it was false leads or maybe it was false sales, but something was false in that incentive program. And they couldn't take her smart car away because they'd already given it to her or whatever, and that's not how those things work. But what they were able to do, rather than press charges, I guess, or getting any legal trouble or serious, you know, problems with the law, they fired her. So she got fired for cheating on that incentive program. So her smart car probably wouldn't have lasted as long as her career there may have. But yet then again, let me backtrack there. I used to work for another big company called MCI WorldCom. And I thought I was kind of set because it was a big company, and I thought I was set for life. This was back in 1999. So I was a young person, I was 24. Finally made it to my first big corporation. Worked there for 2 months and they laid off everyone. And then again at the Home Depot in 2005, I worked for the customer contact center for a large corporation called the Home Depot. And they laid off, I think it was 1,400 people in one day. As Bob Nardelli got a golden parachute for however many billions of dollars as he exited. So that's corporate America. So I say, oh, shame on her for cheating on that raffle. She probably could have had a career for however X years. No, not true. She probably would have been laid off. So I don't believe in cheating on the raffle. I'm not saying way to go cheating on that raffle. So what I'm saying is being laid off or being fired or what have you, probably not the worst punishment. She probably moved on to a much better life after that. And hell, she learned a lesson. So maybe she was young. I don't know who it was. But yeah, you know, so smart cars are cool. I do dig a smart car. But yeah, you can't really trust a corporation to take care of you. You can't, and that's foolishness. Build up your skill set. Get the right words on your resumes. You know, for reals though. You know, make sure that as reference checking becomes much better capable and whatever, that you don't fuck yourself out of a job by putting false references on there or things you didn't really do. So you gotta be careful. Yeah, especially in America. America, we don't keep CVs. Like a CV, I did have one for a hot minute when I was much younger. But everything you've ever done goes on a CV, like everything. And they're difficult. A resume is like America's poor man's CV. It's nothing like a CV. A curriculum vitae, I think is how you pronounce it. Yeah, that's not what we do here in the United States. So anyway, moping home seems to be working. It looks like I will be able to limp all the way home. They still got Christmas lights up on Franklin Street. The weather is good. And heck, you know, maybe I just needed a slower cruise today anyway, instead of some mad dogging on the trail or whatever. So, you know, opportunity, especially with these tires. You know, if it busted out there, it was gonna bust out soon anyway. And that's not the tire's fault. I had the orange, whatever, replace me indicators going, neglected them, didn't think about them, and eventually the tire just couldn't take anymore, and